Plant cells are organized into three different types of tissues. One of the types is called dermal tissues, and dermal tissues are on the outside of the plant. Second type is called vascular tissues, and they're like pipelines running up and down the plant. And the third type of tissue is called cortex. Now, starting with the dermal tissue, remember it's on the outside. So dermal tissue is made up primarily of a type of cell called epidermis, which is the same name as the outside layer of skins of cells in your skin. Epidermal cells, as you might expect, provide protection for the plant, protection particularly against abrasion, and it also can be covered with a waxy substance called cutin, at least on the shoot part of the plant, that helps retain moisture. It keeps moisture from leaving the plant, which is important because otherwise, if you didn't have cutin on the epidermis, the plants would desiccate or dry out. But in the epidermis of roots, and roots have epidermis too, you don't have cutin because you want roots to absorb moisture. So what roots have in order to do that are outgrowths of the cell wall and cell membrane called root hairs that help gather moisture. Epidermal cells can also have pores in them called stomata surrounded by guard cells that allow gas exchange. We'll see some more of that later. Now the second type of tissue that I mentioned was called vascular tissue, and I said there were the pipelines. They're very specialized cells, a group of cells, cell types called xylem, spelled X-Y-L-E-M. Oop, left my chalk over here. And there are a couple types of xylem that you'll see in the lesson, but xylem cells move water from the roots up through the stem and out the leaves. So it's called unidirectional flow of the water. A second type of pipeline cells in the plant, vascular tissue, are called phloem, P-H-L-O-E-M, phloem. And there are a couple types of phloem, too, that you'll read about in the lesson. And phloem moves compounds within the plant, such as sugars that have been produced through photosynthesis in the leaf, but are needed elsewhere in the plant for energy. And that sugar moves in solution, in a water solution, through the phloem pipeline. And then the third type of cell tissue is called the cortex. The cortex makes up the space, the cells that are in the space between the dermal cells on the outside and the pipelines that are running up and down the plant. So the rest of the space is made up with cortex cells. And it's not as if those cells are just placeholders and unimportant. They're actually very important cells. Lost my eraser. And there are three important types of cortex cell. One is called parenchyma. And parenchyma cells have thin walls and make up most of the cortex. Parenchyma cells also have the characteristic of being able to divide. So these cells are very important also if a plant is wounded. The wound response is such that these start to divide and cover over the wound with a type of cell material called callus. It's just a big mass of cells. So parenchyma cells are thin-walled. Then there's a type of thicker-walled cell where the primary wall of the cell becomes thicker, more cellulose in it, and that's called collenchyma, C-O-L-L-E-N-C-H-Y-M-A. Collenchyma cells give the plant some rigidity, and like parenchyma cells, collenchyma are also alive. Both of these cell types are alive. What's cool about collenchyma is they can form strands in the plant, like the strands that you pull down a celery stalk. And if a plant stem is moving in the breeze, then these collenchyma cells can respond by thickening even more to provide more rigidity for that stem so it can stand up to the wind. Because they're alive, they can respond to external stimulus and get thicker. But they're not hard. They provide a flexible strength. And the third type of cell, actually has a secondary cell wall that I'll show in yellow that's laid down on the inside, and it's very rigid. This type of cell is called sclerenchyma, S-C-L-E-R-E-N-C-H-Y-M-A. And this sclerenchyma cell, the secondary wall here, has a lot of lignin in it, and it's the lignin that gives it rigidity. Now, these cells have a couple of uses, and two that are important are that they can form long fibers in plants, and we use some of those fibers ourselves. So, for instance, in making rope, jute is an example, and hemp is another example of a plant fiber that's made up of long strands of sclerenchyma. Sclerenchyma cells are dead, so they don't respond the way collenchyma do to external stimulus, but they do have these thick cells. The other use of important use of sclerenchyma in a plant cell is to cover over things for protection. So the hard shells of a nut, for instance, or the pits inside of a peach, those hard bits are sclerenchyma cells. And if you've eaten a pear, you know there are little bits of grit that you can feel between your teeth when you're eating a pear. That's sclerenchyma cells also.